Whoa, what's up, guys? It's been a while since I've done a commentary, and this is on the game EA Sports MMA, and man, there's just a lot of games coming out recently. I haven't had time to play them all, and this is one of the games that I recently picked up. I picked up like three or four, maybe five in the past 2-3 weeks, I think. First it was Halo Reach, then it was Dead Rising 2, then it was, I think Medal of Honor, and then it was EA MMA, and I got EA MMA as well as Fallout New Vegas on the same day, and I haven't even touched Fallout New Vegas. I've been so busy playing, the games I bought, 2 weeks ago, and, wow, man, there's just so many games coming out right now. It's insane. I don't have time to play them all. But I really do love this game, I gotta say. It's just a shame that I know it won't get views, I guess. Because I don't really know why. I guess MMA is just not popular with everyone at the moment. I don't really know. Heaven forbid I actually get views on a game I enjoy playing. Gotta play all these frustrating FPS games. But I do really, really like this game. I like it way more than UFC 2010. And don't get me wrong, UFC 2010 is it's a good game for what it is. It's not as good as 2009. There are some flaws with it. And I think EA MMA far surpasses UFC 2010 for a number of reasons. For one, the striking system is just way better. In UFC, it's not about combos, it's not about light strikes, it's not about game plans, it's about landing heavy, super powerful punches, and that's it. Light strikes really don't have a purpose, whereas in this game, pumping the jab, using jabs and light strikes actually serve a purpose. It's just really, it's more true to the sport than something like the UFC games, or UFC 2010 is. Now, is this game better than UFC 2009? I don't know. I think it's a more realistic experience. It's too early to say. I've only played EA MMA for about 6 hours total, probably. But I should probably give you the details on this match. This is actually an online match against my friend Bubba. He got the game a few days ago, and I'm using the Total Strike Control system, which is kind of like Fight Night's striking system for this game, for MMA, I mean. He's using the opposite system, which is called like Classic, and it's basically use the face buttons to punch and kick as opposed to the right stick. There's no real, I mean, I don't know, I don't think there's any real advantage or disadvantage to either. All I know is that the designers apparently designed it to where it's just preference which one you like better. So I might try the classic mode and see if I like it better. But for now, I'm digging the Total Strike Control pretty much. We're on the ground here, and I'm in his full guard. And this is a good match to show off the ground fighting as well as the stand-up system, because Hendo and King Mo are those type of fighters where they can... They're like striker wrestlers, you know what I mean? Like, they could strike, they could wrestle, they can take you down. So this is a good fight to really show, I guess, the ground game off, as well as the striking game. Good mix of both in this fight. Bubba was actually kicking my ass on the feet a lot, and I would always try to take it to the mat if I was in trouble. Right there, he hits me with two heavy shots and almost KOs me, or not KOs me, but he almost rocks me. Gets my head meter all the way down, and I shoot for a takedown. That's a good tip, though. If you know someone, if you're hurting someone on the feet, always be ready to sprawl. Expect a takedown or a clinch or something, and be sure to have your thumb ready to press the B button if you're using the classic control scheme to block the takedown or the clinch attempt. There are a few strikers in this game. The really good strikers like Kung Lee and Scott Smith, they have actually a sprawl auto knee. So if you rock someone on the feet and they try to shoot on you, You can, if you sprawl out, you can actually get a knee that does really heavy damage, and it'll pretty much give you an auto rock from the feet. So if you're somebody that likes, you know, to keep it on the feet, you feel that's your strength, I'd highly suggest picking a character with that ability, because that ability just rapes. But Hendo and King Mo don't have that ability. They just have the basic sprawl. And that was a pretty even round, I think. I'm going to clip it because I forgot to skip the replays. And that's pretty cool. You can't really do that in UFC. You can actually touch gloves and have them actually connect like in real life. So that's pretty neat. I'm going to come in with an overhand right and just... basically, what I'm trying to do, I know that he has an advantage in the stand-up. Basically, what I'm trying to do is be more patient, counter his strikes with takedowns and stuff. I think I have the advantage on the ground over Bubba. He knows this a lot, and he'll stand up even from advantageous positions just because he doesn't want to get reversed on the ground or swept or whatever. And it's understandable. I get full mount here, fully postured up. He's in a lot of trouble. He does manage to pull me back down though, lower my posture so I can't just rain down blows on him. And then he gets me back to half guard. The way the ground game works in this game is that if you're using the default control scheme, A is a minor pass, B is to deny a pass or counter a pass, and up and A is a major pass. Now up and like major passes will give you, it's basically a double minor pass in a sense. It'll basically pass two times for the price of one, but the risk there is if the other person counters, they will sweep you and be on top. Minor passes can't be reversed, they can just be blocked, but they will not, I mean, if you stay into a, oh, he rocks me with a body shot right there, a counter body shot. He actually rocked me with, and that's pretty cool. You can get rocked with leg shots, headshots, body shots, whatever. In this game, that's pretty cool. What was I saying though? I don't even remember. Oh, I was talking about the passing and all that. You have to realize though that if neither person makes an attempt to, you know, pass from a position, you'll eventually get stood up. So it's kind of like it's a chess match. You really gotta mask your, I guess, pass attempts with strikes, because the way this game works, as he actually sweeps me here, you can actually sweep someone if you're in their guard. They can sweep you, I mean. So he's just lighting me up on the feet. I gotta get out of there. Luckily, Hendo has a chin rating of like 99 in this game. He's really hard to rock. He's really hard to ever one punch knockout. I guess is the proper way to say that. He does hit me with a flying knee back there, then lights me up with a combo. And I think they made King Mo striking too good in this game, honestly. Does too much damage, in my opinion. King Mo is not that good of a striker in real life. I mean, he's okay, but he's not, you know, he's not going to, honestly, he's not going to hurt someone like Hendo unless he lights him up with, like, six power punches in a row. But, anyway... I don't know where I'm going with this. I think the fight is coming. No, never mind. I start lighting him up on the feet. I know he's going to shoot, so I sprawl, and I'm going to punish him in the sprawl with shots to the head. And one important thing to note, guys, is that you cannot, I don't think you can sprawl while constantly blocking your face on the feet. So I know a big habit for UFC is to always block your face when you're not punching. It's not always a wise decision to do that, especially against someone with good takedown offense like King Mo or Hendo, because I mean, you're susceptible to a takedown if you're blocking, completely blocking, walking around completely blocking all the time. So yeah, as you see there, King Mo's stamina is pretty low. And if I had a good submission character, I would have already tried to lock in a submission. The submission system and the way it works is different in this game from UFC. You can actually deny submission attempts. They're basically kind of like transitions. You can actually deny those submission attempts if you're very savvy on the ground. You have to open up the submission attempts with strikes. You can't just auto lock it in, which is pretty cool. And Yeah, I'll explain in more detail the submission system after I get it down. I'm still learning how to properly work it, but I hit a huge overhand right here, and I really bring his head meter down. He gets too cocky and tries to strike with me again, eats a spinning back fist, and I just light him the hell up, knock him down with a vicious combo, and just beat the hell out of him. And watch this, guys. I'm actually going to slow-mo it right here so you can see exactly what a sick combo this was. I was surprised I was able to pull this off. Look at this. Spinning back fist. Just nasty. Takes down his head meter. Light him up with some jabs, then a hook, then a big overhand right. And then from there on, he's just completely out almost. And I just beat on him for the TKO victory. So I turned that around pretty well. I was losing on the feet pretty much the whole fight. Come back with a very nice combo. He got too cocky, kind of like King Mo does in real life. And I got his ass knocked out. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you are on the fence about buying EA MMA, I mean, if you like MMA games and want a realistic, in my opinion, simulation, a game that's really true to the sport, I'd say pick up this game. It's a lot of fun. It's looking to be, I think, the best MMA game probably ever. I have to reserve that judgment for when I play it more. But so far, I'm loving this game, and I highly suggest it. It's a lot of fun once you realize, or once you know how to play it. And if you guys enjoyed the video, please rate it, because rating it helps the video get noticed, helps it get views. And let me know if you guys would like to see kind of a tutorial video for this game, how to play it more in depth. I'm still learning things myself, but I do know a lot about this game. I'd love to share those things with you, but I don't want to do it if it's not going to get views. So let me know in the comments if you'd like to see that, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace out.